video into out front of embattled Republican Congressman George Santos, making even more questionable claims, this time in a Brazilian podcast, which was just released, but actually was recorded 2 weeks before his laundry list of lies about his education, work history, family life, religion were first exposed, right? So this was back when he didn't know anybody knew that all that was false. So these new claims we're finding out include that he was mugged in Manhattan, which an NYPD source says there is no record of, that he survived an assassination attempt, and that he'd donate his entire congressional salary to charity, which today he refused to say he would still do. Eva McKent is out front.
Embattled Congressman George Santos back at work on Capitol Hill today, dodging tough questions from reporters as new revelations about public claims he's made continue to pile up.
Judge, primeiro lugar, obrigado.
The latest coming from a recently released interview with a Brazilian podcast that was taped in December, shortly after Santos won election in New York's 3rd District. Santos claimed in the interview, done in Portuguese, that he was mugged on Fifth Avenue in New York City in the summer of 2021 as he was walking out of a commercial building in broad daylight.
They robbed me, took my bag, my shoes, and watch.
But a source with the New York Police Department tells CNN there's no record Santos reported the alleged crime. The lack of a report doesn't mean the alleged incident didn't take place, but it draws further scrutiny of the claim made by Santos, who has already admitted to lying about key parts of his biography. Another claim Santos made in the interview that's raising eyebrows, that he survived an assassination attempt.
We have suffered life attack, assassination attempt, threatening letter, having to have security guards and police escorts standing in front of our house.
But Santos did not go into any further details or provide any corroborating evidence. In the same podcast, Santos suggested he was living comfortably enough to make a pledge to donate his congressional salary to charity. He declined to answer questions about that vow on Tuesday. The 34-year-old did say he would cooperate with a potential upcoming House ethics investigation.
Will you cooperate with that?
Absolutely.
Santos wasn't among his colleagues at the new member reception this evening at the White House, though he was invited.
I just didn't have the time. It was on my schedule. Sorry.
What are you doing instead?
Constituent services.
Santos already facing questions about his future plans, including whether he'll run for re-election.
Wow, it's so early for that question. I just got here, guys.
And Aaron, I spent the day asking. Santos's congressional staff about the many claims he made in that podcast interview, despite my best efforts, did not get a response. Meanwhile, the Concerned Citizens of New York 3, that's a bipartisan group organized, though, by a Democrat, they're continuing to turn up the heat, now calling on Republican Conference Chair Elise Stefanik, their fellow New Yorker, to use her leadership position in the GOP to push Santos out. Aaron.
Eva, thank you very much. And I want to go now to Flora Thompson DeVoe. She is the director of research for Radio Novello and produced that podcast interview that you just heard with George Santos. So, Flora, I really appreciate your time. And I guess I want to start off with, you know, we laid out the timing, right? You did this interview with Santos after he won, but before the world knew that all these things were lies. But you heard him telling you all these stories. What were you thinking as he told you this?
Yeah, that we did. The story was pitched to us at Novello by a reporter at Piauí magazine, João Batista Jr., and he and we were really interested in Santos as a character, you know, as this person who came from the background that he came from, who arrived at the values that he arrived at, who's made this, you know, impressive, has had this impressive career, or had at that point in time. So we sat down for an interview with him, and when we came out of it, I thought we didn't have a story. It was sort of a blend of cliches, pl- platitudes, these really unsatisfying talking points. João was particularly interested in George Santos's comfortable life, and he sort of reacted to any questions that we had by calling them indiscreet about his finances. But in general, it just seemed like it was a blend of sort of some, there was some fake news, some fabulism, and I made the judgment call that we didn't need to give this guy more oxygen. And well, by now that quickly became a moot point.
Right. But interesting when you say you felt that there was fabulism. I mean, some of the things that he said, and as you point out, that every time you asked about finances, he said indiscreet, tried to punt it or walk away from it. I mean, I feel like that's a really significant details that you're sharing. When he talked to you about his congressional salary, he obviously promised to donate to charity. And it wasn't just a throwaway thing like, I'm going to donate to charity. He laid out to you specifically how he was going to do it. Let me just play that exchange.
It's $174,000 a year, which I've even decided I'm not going to receive. I'm going to receive, but I'm going to donate. So I have already chosen four NGOs to which each quarter I will be delivering a check for the net profit of my salary.
Okay, incredibly specific. He's picked four NGOs every quarter. They're getting a check. So then today he was asked about that very promise that he made on your podcast. And here's what he said.
On the Brazilian podcast, you said you donate your salary. Do you still plan to do that?
Do you think any charity will ever see that salary?
Unclear. In the same story, we also spoke to the man who was on the receiving end of the bad checks that Santos wrote in 2008. And he, upon hearing that Santos was planning to donate his salary, said that he would like to be put on a list of potential recipients. So there's that.
So I want to play a little bit more of what he said to you about that alleged mugging in Midtown Manhattan. I just want to be clear. He said it happened in broad daylight, walking out of a commercial building, that he was robbed, right? It was, and it was near Trump Tower. Here's what he said.
No verão de 2021.
It was in summer of 2021 on Fifth Avenue and 55th. I was robbed by two men. Before you ask, they weren't black. They were white, for that matter. They robbed me, took my bag, my shoes, and watch.
So robbed him, his bag, shoes, and watch. Obviously, that's a searing experience, and it's very specific. An NYPD source tells CNN, though, that there's no record of him reporting a mugging. What do you make of that, Flora?
I mean, it's one of my favorite exchanges in the interview, just the way that Jean-Baptiste just asked, so they took your shoes in the middle of Fifth Avenue. You know, there was it didn't pass the smell test immediately. And I don't know, it struck us as almost a fable or perhaps a horror story meant to make a point about how bad crime is in New York. And told this story, I found him telling it to one other show, but I kind of reasoned that the reason he might be, well, I thought, you know, if this happened to him, why hasn't he spoken about it more? Because, you know, crime, you know, rising crime was a big part of his platform. So that doesn't really make sense. And then I thought maybe he's choosing to tell it to us now because he thinks that maybe it'll pass the smell test for a Brazilian audience who's less familiar with New